I'm gonna. Yes. And especially before computers, it was even more terrifying. I think I'm gonna. I put Bishop E7, he's gonna go for. Oh, I didn't get rid of the disk space problem. That's annoying. Let me just hit stop recording. Okay.
Gotta get ready for this game. I'm not worried about Queen F3. He's not gonna go for that. Cause usually he wants this, Queen G3, castles, and Bishop H6, but he's already done this, so he's already wasted a tempo. He's likely gonna play F3, Queen D2, and try and mate me quickly. I'm threatening B4 in some variations, but not quite yet. Thank you. Okay.
He's going to go after each other. I'm going to castle into it. I have to castle, otherwise he sacks. And now I'm free to bring my knight to d7, b6. Or knight d7, b6, knight d7. I'm going to go after this bishop. Okay, obviously I can't do this because he plays knight c6, so. Alright.
He's trying to kill me. He just wants to mate me. Straight away. This is a very ferocious Alpha Zero attack.
Gee. It's a high combined elo. I tell you.
Thanks, Andromeda. He just wants to straight mate me. I'm gonna try and trap this bishop. Some ideas of knight b6, b4 something, maybe knight c5. Not that coherent yet, but Bishop e6 doesn't work yet because there's bishop h4 check, so none of that works yet. Shouldn't give the piece for two pieces for a rook like that. I don't know what I'm doing yet, but I'll figure it out soon. Probably knight b6, then knight d7. I've analyzed this before, 10 years ago. The bishop on b7 doesn't make much sense, running up against this chain. Better to leave it at home. Guard this point because he's going to play g6 in the future. So he also has knight f5 and knight d5 ideas all over the place. Just gotta play the right tournaments. Gotta get your FIDE over 2500, that's the most important thing. And then one more norm, probably. Idea knight b6. Maybe bishop d7, b4, a5, a4. Obviously he has a3 in some lines, but then there's knight c5, and his queenside can get weak too. Knight b6, knight d7, knight e5, knight c4. Meanwhile, he's just coming hard with h4, g5, castle long, g6. If I take on h6, h5. Just mate, so this is a good way to get mated quickly, just to play this. That's why I asked to play black this game, so that you guys could see some action. This guy's really crazy. He can definitely hurt me at any moment. Any moment I can get hurt in this game. No, depends on the player. For me, I'm a more wild player, so I had two norms for many years. It's have to get the rating, play the right tournaments, get over 25. I mean, it depends. I haven't played a tournament in over a year, so it's not that big a deal. I was playing all the time, 2015 through 17. He's gonna castle long. Then g5, knight b6, h4, knight d7, g5. I've analyzed this. This is very complicated. Surprised he would do that. It's a little surprising. I'm gonna sit down now. I mean, I didn't think he would do that, because I have bishop h4, so I wonder what his idea is.
I gotta take it, so.
Knight d5, bishop h4, check, no? Very aggressive idea. I don't think this is enough. I think he should have just gone normal. You think it's sound? Maybe. Maybe it is. Hope it is. He wouldn't just do this for no reason. But it's not coming to me right now. Guess he's gonna play King E2. Main idea is Queen E7, Knight E7, Queen E7, Queen D5. Picks up the rook. Sort of. But I mean, I'm gonna play Bishop H4, no? I mean, this is a little extreme. He has a pawn and a g-file now. I mean, I see the point. The g-file is coming, so. Gf now. And we're in for battle. Yeah, because he's coming straight like this with threats everywhere. Thank you.
This looks really good for what? Hiding. Yeah. I should watch his master class. It's funny. It's funny. I want pressure on this. This bishop wasn't doing anything anyway. I'm going to play King H8 next move. Make him work. Okay. Obviously, this is coming, so. I'm going to make him work. King H8, bishop H6, I take it. Queen takes. Bishop F6. Should be holding. So is Rook G8 probably holding. Okay. King H8, if Rook G4, then Knight E5. If Bishop D4, then I have F6 in some lines. Maybe. Okay, I have to play King H8. Queen C3. There's some F6. There's also Knight F6 starting to take this. Maybe. Again, in some variations. But if he mates me, he mates me. I just don't. I'm skeptical. But, you know. I could be wrong.
Nadal's gonna win the Australian Open. I'm pretty sure about that.
You can quote me on that. Thank you. Yeah, I've been the last 3 years.
We'll see. I mean, maybe he just wants to play Rook G2 and Rook G1. That G file is extremely problematic. Problem is, if I play Knight F6, he plays Bishop D4, totally pinning. Who knows? He might have time for Rook G2 and Rook G1. I also have Rook G8, so. Then there's Bishop H6. I don't know.
Why I have the wrong camera all the time. Sorry about that.
Okay.
Ah. Ah.
Intense game. Yes, yoga is on. Very creative game by my opponent. Alright, this game's heating up. I'm gonna sit down a little bit. Not really sure what's happening. I'll let the play come to me. If I ever do play f6 to defend, this knight f4 knight e6 is incredibly strong, so a move like queen c3 is very viable, to say the least. Yeah, I ate some yogurt. I think queen c3 is a good move. As it dawns upon me. There's knight e5 there, f4, I could sack it back. Bishop d5, bishop d5. Knight d7. If he plays fe first, rook c8. If he takes on a8, queen a8. Something like queen e4, I'm not sure. Hello.
Oh.
Oh. I mean, if queen c3, I play rook g8, there's bishop h6. Queen c3, there's simply bishop f6. And if he plays knight f6, then just knight takes f6. But then the rook g7, king g7, rook g1, king h8. Bishop d4, I have knight d7. So it seems like I have some defensive resources, to say the least. So queen c3, bishop f6 should be right. Obviously, I can't just threaten to take this yet, because I lose my rook on a8. Bishop d5, bishop takes d5, and the rook hangs. So, it's going to take some efforts to unravel. I mean, let me give him some more time. Okay, I'm giving him more time. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, should be enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. I don't want to win this game from rushing him. I want to prove that this sacrifice is either correct or incorrect. I'd love it to be correct, because if it's correct, then I'd be very happy to see a move like knight f5 and knight d5 working. Personally, I think he should have just castled and gone for the normal barbaric mayhem, and that's very hard to play against, but he wanted more. He wanted to blow me off the court, so to speak, using the g-file. Yeah.
And here we are. Where? At what point, knight c6? Right now? I mean, it's his move. He's going to threaten mate on g7 in some form. Again, moves like f6 weaken the e5 square considerably. His king is very safe on e2, nestled behind these pawns. But if he does play f4 and opens things up, maybe I could counterattack his king. But for now, yeah, no, it's White's move. Ugh. I'm tired already from this game. Ugh.
I don't know. Andromeda, are you enjoying the game so far? Very intense. This guy's very strong. It's one of those moments where you sometimes want to save energy. You save energy because you don't know where your opponent's going to move. You don't want to exhaust yourself thinking about every single thing. So sometimes you wait until he's moved. Because you know you're going to have that think when he moves. You look at some preliminary things. But in a position like this, it's already going to go crazy, so you might not want to go too crazy. Yeah, he's really gone. Gone for it. The good news about moves like this is that I have to take. So it makes my life easy. If I get mated, I get mated. And if I don't, I don't. So in that sense, it's not the worst thing in the world. But obviously no one wants to get wrecked like that. I don't think that's good, by the way. But, you know, it's going to be based on one move. Obviously, I take and play King H8, so he has Bishop H6. Then there's Rook G8. Yeah, I don't think that's great. I don't know. If he wins, but I hope he runs out of steam. King G7, Rook G1, King H8. Bishop H6. Rook G8. Queen C3. Knight E5. I don't want to take it too soon. Because if I get mated, it looks embarrassing. But can't worry about being embarrassed. You gotta try and win as black. You're gonna get embarrassed. You gotta get over that and play. So I'm taking it, obviously. I mean, there was no other move. And here we are. Okay, obviously. King H8, now what?
like that wins. Because just queen h6 is next. Maybe I should have played f6? Although f6 looks horrible. No, I know who I'm playing. There's no doubt who I'm playing. Great player. Do I need to sack the queen? And play like... Oh, my friend is... In these type of positions, he's one of the best players in the world. That's for sure. Maybe among the best in the world. That's clear. I mean, I suppose I could just give the queen. But, no. Rook and two pieces. In these positions, yes, he would beat Magnus. It's just Magnus wouldn't want to get these positions. You could laugh all you want, but it's true. I know that. Brilliant conception. I like this. Bishop b6. I like that a lot. I had a feeling it might be. Maybe I should have taking the knight first. Well, I don't know. Then there's rook g1. That looks ridiculous. I don't know. This human, the one I'm playing, is one of the best attackers in the world. This human considers it. No, it's not Larry. my friend contributed to my book. So found a beautiful variation in my book. Definitely contributed. Jay's the only move for me, unfortunately for me. Rook a7, queen d6, bishop c7, and queen c5. And that's the end. Yeah, rook a7, he plays f6, f6, and mate. Yeah, so too bad. Great game. But that's an immortal game, I mean. I'm proud to lose this game. No, I don't know why he's adding time, because I'm just going to resign. But I think maybe the move order was wrong. Maybe do it first, maybe. It's interesting. Maybe now. Just knight d7 now is right. First. No, I mean, this is very nice. This concept. No, it's not theory. There is no theory in this position. I'll let him play, finish the game. There are no moves here for me. Actually, are there? Can I play knight c6? Is f4, right? Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's been played many times. He's very good at it. Well, thank God it's Friday, everyone. Thank God it's Friday. If you had a game like this, you might want to go get a drink after the game. Well, congratulations to my friend. Great game. And let's see it. Ooh. Yeah, no, he'll beat Magnus in this position. Alright. I might be back later. I'll see you all for now. If you enjoyed these games, feel free to donate.
It should go to my friend for his brilliant,
absolute masterpiece of a game. I mean, unbelievable game. Or subscribe, but I mean, absolutely. Great game. Alright, I'm not going to analyze this with this weak engine. Thank you, Andromeda.
You might not ever see a game like that again.
Unless, of course, we deal with Alpha Zero. Similar stuff. What a brilliant game. I'm happy to lose that game. Tal said similar when he lost to Nezmedinov. The happiest day of his life was losing to Nezmedinov. That's what he said. I feel similarly about this game. Okay, here I should play knight d7. First. Queen on c7, I should do this first. Okay. This weak engine will. I don't know about bishop d6. Yeah. It likes white. Oh, winning already. So it's winning for him. I don't know. Can't make up its mind. Yes. Okay, it's winning. See, the computer doesn't see. Wins. I mean, everything else loses. This move surprised me. Yeah, I'm very happy that the knight f5 is winning. Makes me very happy. As you can see, it's winning completely. And other than queen c7, I played well, but queen c7 loses. So that's the end. I should just play this move. He hasn't played g4 yet, but he's going to. I should just play here, maybe. His bishop... He has 96 here. Yeah. I don't want to play bishop e7. I really don't. I'll have to think about it. Yeah, it's one of the best games I've lost. Ever. No, this was not on Kasparov's. How is it possible that Stockfish doesn't see Rook G7? Because Stockfish is not a god. Stockfish is doing many things wrong. That's why I got crushed by the new computer AlphaZero, which also will be doing many things wrong. But everyone wants to think that computers are, you know, the ultimate thing. You know, my opponent has, you know, devoted many years to these positions. Probably the best in the world in these positions. So, why would it be surprising that Stockfish can't see these moves? Bishop b6 surprises me, but I knew at this position that this is going to be rough. With the king on e2. This position is bad news. Yeah, but I think this is just winning by force. And this could be an easy AlphaZero Stockfish game. By my friend. You know, it's just... No one's heard of him, but they heard of the computer. So now bishop b7 is given... I mean, it's all lost. It's all force lost, so... I don't know. Might need to go to a bar after this game. But I couldn't be happier. You know? Couldn't be happier losing this game. Might have to put this one straight on YouTube. Just in a beautiful, beautiful game. But let's think about how we could have improved in this position. I don't want to play bishop b7, but I want to get my pieces somehow like this. Maybe I have to play bishop b7. Probably queen c7 now. Probably. I mean, he does have g4, no? F3. I don't know. I'd have to think about it. When you lose a game like this, you feel like you forgot how to play. So, great game. Congratulations. To my opponent. Beautiful. And you guys could analyze it yourselves. See what you find, but this is dead lost. Oof. There's no defense. Boom, boom, check. And over. Thank you. No, I mean, we don't know each other, Chess Wiz, but I'm telling you that Djokovic is gonna lose. Nadal's gonna win that match. His serve is better. I think he's gonna beat him. Djokovic is in great form. He usually does beat Nadal in these moments, but I think Nadal's gonna win this time. As for this game, this is a world-class game. One of the best games I've seen. It's not every day get a position like this. So, I'll be back maybe. See y'all. Beautiful game.